Inverter is a device that converts the DC source to AC source. Actually, this is one of the most important part in nowadays, because we can see there are many sources such as solar energy source, solar panels, which generates directly DC quantities. And we know that our most of the load are AC loads. They have inductors or capacitors into it. So we need to just create an interface between these DC sources and AC loads. So what we do, we use these inverters. These inverters convert your DC supply to AC supply, and then it can be transferred to some load. So let us start this. So we will be starting a single phase inverter, and let us just see a circuit that is able to convert your DC source to AC source. Okay, let us see. So we are having a DC source and a switch which can be closed and open. Then we can have our load. Let us use a resistive load only. Later on, we will include our inductors as well. And this, the DC source is a 3-point source. Okay, so this is V/2 and this is V/2. So mostly we have in DC positive terminals and negative terminals. But these type of DC sources has one positive terminal, one zero terminal, and one negative terminal. And after this, we will be having one more switch, S2. We can define our terminals of our load as to be A and B, where B is positive and A is negative. So this is our VL. Okay, so I'll be using three notions in this circuit. The first notion is that the switches are unidirectional. It can unidirectional switches. It means it can conduct the current in only one direction. So here S1 can conduct in this direction and S2 can conduct in this direction. So this is called unidirectional switches. It cannot conduct the current in reverse direction. The second point is that these switches are forced commutated. You have learned many type of commutation while studying your thyristors. Okay, how to switch on those switches. So here forced commutation will be used, means whenever we will say that the switch has to be on, then it will on, and when we will say the switch has to be off, it will be off. Okay, so this is called forced commutation. And the third is our 3-point DC voltage source. Okay, let us analyze this circuit in two parts. First, what we will do, we will switch S1 on and S2 off. It means what will be the circuit? The circuit will be like this. The switch S1 is on. So above is the closed path. So we are having VL and V/2, the DC source. Then in the below closed circuit is open. Okay, So what will be VL? So we can just apply the KVL in this loop. So we can say minus V by 2 plus VL will be equal to 0, KVL, basic KVL. So from here we can say that VL is equal to V by 2. Okay, until and unless the switch S1 is on and S2 is off. Let us see the second case. Second case is that S1 we will make it off and S2 will make on. Then what will be the circuit? Again, you can draw it as you have drawn for the first part. S1 is off. Okay, plus minus VL. So the lower circuit is closed, and we can just identify the current in the first case. So this was the current. Okay, let us say this is I1, and then in the second case this will be I2. So I2 will be flowing in the load like this. Okay, and in the first case I1 is flowing from the in the node in this direction. So from let us denote the nodes B and A. So in the first case, when S1 is on and S2 is off, then I1 is flowing from B to A, and our load voltage is V by 2. Okay, in the second case, I2 is now the current in the load is flowing from A to B. Okay, and if you apply the KVL, then we can see here that minus V by 2 minus VL is equal to 0. So VL is equal to now minus V by 2. Just see here. First, the load voltage is V by 2, and second, the load voltage is minus V by 2. So here we can draw a simple voltage profile of load voltage profile as per time. So this is VL. So until and unless S1 is on, let us say for T1 time the S1 is on, and for capital T minus T1 time, the S2 is on. So for this much time, S1 is on, and for T minus T2, S2 is on. Okay. So what will be VL till T1? VL is, you can say, the first circuit, your left hand, left part of the circuit in your left section of this screen. So here you can see VL is equal to V by 2. What is V by 2 at T is equal to T1? Okay, and from T1 to T, when S2 is on, then what is VL? VL is minus V by 2. So we can say that this is minus V by 2. Minus V by 2. And again, if you switch off your S2 and S1 is on, then again V by 2, and similarly you can proceed. Okay. So just by switching on and off these two switches, what we are able to do, we are able to create a voltage across the load that is changing its polarity. So for if T1 is T by 2, we are switching on it for half of the time. So for T1 it is V by 2, for capital T minus T1 it is minus V by 2. Okay. So this waveform is also called as square wave waveform. Square wave waveform. You can see this is not a DC. This clearly looks do not matches the DC profile, because DC is what? If there is a DC signal, then it will be constant throughout with respect to time. It will always maintain its polarity. But here, the load voltage polarity is changing. First, it was V by 2, then it is minus V by 2. This very much, this character is similar to AC quantity. This is not exactly AC signal which you have studied, the sinusoidal signal, but it's somewhat, it has a characteristic of alternating its polarity with respect to time. Okay, so if you want to just analyze this, what this waveform is and how it could be treated as AC, then we must do a bit of Fourier analysis. What is Fourier analysis? Fourier analysis just converts your any periodic signal. So Fourier, we call it Fourier transform. So what it does? Fourier transform converts periodic signal. So what is periodic signal? A signal that that repeats itself after a set time. Okay, so Fourier transform converts periodic signal into sinusoidal signal, set of many sinusoidal signals. Sinusoidal plus cosinusoidal plus DC. Okay, so what I just want to say that let us say the load voltage, what we are having the load voltage. So what is load voltage? Load voltage is VL is V by 2 for time 0 to T1 and minus V by 2 for T1 to T, let us say this equality sign. Okay, so this VL is changing with respect to time. So this is our signal. So we can convert our VLT such as it is equal to a constant term A naught, let us say 2 A naught plus AN cos N omega t, where n can be from 1 to infinity, plus bn sine n omega t, where n is equal to 1 to infinity. Okay, and here omega is what? 2 pi by t. Okay, t is the time period. Okay, so we have converted our VLT into what? Into a constant term, DC quantity, a cosinusoidal signal and a sinusoidal signal. This is set of cosinusoidal and sinusoidal signal. There are many sinusoidal and cosinusoidal signals. Okay. And where this constant is what? Let me write first AN. So AN is 1 upon T by 2, 0 to T, VLT, and cos of N omega T. and Bn is equal to 1 upon T by 2 0 to T BLT sine of n omega t. Okay, and A naught is equal to 1 upon T by 2 0 to T BLT. Okay, so this is this what Fourier proposed. Okay, so in this we can solve for our load profile. We can convert our load profile in this term. So for this we can just put on the value of VLT and integrate these things, An, Bn, and A naught value. So we need to find all these quantities. Now to find these, a shortcut is there. What is the shortcut? So shortcut is that if Ft is an even function, what is an even function? In even function, ft is equal to f of minus t. So if a function is even, then this integral ft cos of n omega t 0 to t, this is equal to then this quantity 0 to t ft sine of n omega t is equal to 0. And what is this? This is your Bn. If the function is even. And if ft is an odd function, what is an odd function? In odd function, ft is equal to minus of f of minus t. Okay, in that case, a naught is equal to 0, which is what? 0 to 2 ft dt. Okay, and an is also equal to 0, which is what? 0 to t ft cos of n omega t dt is equal to 0. So here as well we have to integrate that with dt. Okay, so what we have to do, we need not calculate all the constants. Just what we can do, we can identify our load profile. Is it even function or odd function? Okay, and then we will apply our shortcuts. So what is our load profile? Let us see. So our load profile is like this, na? Square waveform. Let us extend this in negative as well. So this is T. So this is this load profile is VL is an odd function. Okay. Even function are symmetrical to your y-axis. like cosine, if you see cosine, so cosine is like this. Now you see y-axis is like behaving like a mirror to this waveform. It is the left hand side, left hand and right hand portion is symmetrical to each other. That is an even function. So our VL is an odd function. Okay, if it is an odd function, then as per our shortcuts, A naught and An is going to be zero. Okay, so now let us calculate the remaining thing, Bn. So what is Bn? Bn is 1 upon time period 0 to t, our VLt sine of n omega t. You see, it is a very simple integral, very, very simple. So what you just write down the VL. So VL is from 0 to t, t1. What is VL? VL is V by 2. So we can write V by 2 sine of n omega t dt. So this is a simple integral which we have to solve. And plus from t1 to t. So what it is, this is minus V by 2. Okay, now just integrate these two quantities. So what it will be, it is 1 by t integral of sine n omega t is minus cos n omega t. This is v by 2 into minus cos of n omega t divided by n omega. And we can just take the limits over here. And in this part as well, what we can do, it will be minus V by 2 of minus cos n omega t by n omega. And this will start from T1 to T. Now just solve this. Bn can be written as, is equal to taking V by 2 out, so V by 2 T and minus of cos n omega T upon n omega limit from 0 to T1 plus cos of n omega. So here it should be t, small t, n omega t upon n omega from t1 to t. This is what we have to calculate. So n omega also we can take out. So 2n and omega, if you write 2 pi by t into so this will be constant. Now here we can write minus cos of n omega t1 minus of minus plus cos of 0, that is 1, plus cos of n omega t minus cos of n omega t1. So here we can see omega replacing omega 2 pi by t. So this term will become cos of n into 2 pi. So we can write here, so t here also t will be cancelled. So we can write 4 pi n. And this will be minus 2 times cos of n omega t1 and cos of 2 pi into n, where n is an integer. So this will also become 1. So v we can write cos 0 1 and cos n 2 pi as well 1. So v upon 2 pi n into 1 minus cos of n omega. So we can just solve this by putting our T1 is equal to T by 2. So let us say that switch S1 is switched on for half time and switch S2 is switched on for another half time. So T1 is equal to T by 2. So if we put this, then it will be V upon 2 pi n. Your Vn will become V upon 2 pi n 1. Minus cos of replacing omega as to be 2 pi by t and t1 as to be t by 2. So it will be equal to Vn will be equal to V by 2 pi n 1 minus cos of n pi. Okay, so we can see that for if for n to be even, if n is even, then cos of n pi will become 1 and Vn will become 0. And for n is equal to odd, your n pi will become your cos n pi will become minus 1. So Vn will become 2 v by 2 pi n, which will be v by pi n. Okay, so we can write our vlt as to be n to be 2n plus 1 to infinity, where capital N is 1, 2, 3, all the integers. So it will be V upon pi n cos of, it will be V, so it will be sine n omega. So if we can expand to three terms, then we can see that V upon n for n is equal to 1, V pi, it will be sine omega t. Then for n is equal to 3, we can see V upon 3 pi sine 3 omega t. And for n is equal to 5, we can see that it is V upon 5 pi sine 5 omega t till infinity. So we can see there are many sinusoidal quantity, many AC quantity. If you say it is the first one, this is second term, this is third. So the first AC signal is if it is its frequency is f, then the second one will be having frequency. If this is having a frequency f, then the second term will be having 3f. You see, it is 3 into omega. And the third term is 5 into f. And it will just keep on increasing. The frequency will keep on increasing. We say it is order. This is our fundamental frequency, fundamental AC quantity, which is at f frequency. And the signal AC signal, which is at three times of the fundamental frequency, we call it third harmonics. And this third term is called fifth harmonic. Okay, and so on, the order will increase. And one more thing to observe here is that you can see the fundamental frequency signal is having an amplitude of V by pi. And the third harmonics is having amplitude of V upon 3 pi. So the the amplitude of the harmonics is decreasing as per its order. if we can draw the signals, and let us say this is our fundamental, and this is unity, then our third harmonics will be having a 0.3 up to 0.3 amplitude will be just 0.3. So we can say this will be having 3 times frequency, so 3 cycles will be there. Okay. So this is our fundamental, and this is at third harmonic. This is our third harmonic. Okay. And similarly, we can draw the fifth harmonic as well. So the signal which is having higher voltage amplitude, it will generate higher current. And therefore, its effect on the output side will be highest. So we can say that VLT is nearly equal to its fundamental voltage. So the signal which we have created, the square wave waveform, is exactly similar to a sinusoidal waveform. Its behavior is similar to a sinusoidal waveform. Just the other harmonics will just create losses in the system. It will not create the output. It will not transfer the energy from the source to load. It will just create losses in the system. Sometimes these harmonics are so high that we need to filter out before the power is supplied to the load. Okay, its effect you can just if you want to just learn something more about harmonics, you can always read a book from Elgar. So it will be interesting to learn more thing about harmonics and what is the effect of these harmonics in the system. For the time being, we can just concentrate on this fundamental frequency, and this whole analysis is just to make you sure that your square waveform or any periodic signal is equivalent to a sinusoidal signal. Okay, so we can move on. Let us understand the operation of single phase inverter when it feeds the RL load. So the same circuit we are having. A 3-point DC source. Resistance and inductor. A source and switch. So this is S1 and this is S2. So here the current can flow in this direction. In this switch, the current can flow in this direction. And here we can denote our RL. So we can give terminal name A and B and terminal polarity. So let us say this is plus and this is minus. So the voltage across this node is Now let's assume that a current at t equal to zero, this current is flowing in the circuit. is the lower switch was on and the current was flowing in the lower circuit. So this is the current that is going at t is equal to zero. Okay, at a steady state. Now what we need to do? We need to switch on our S1 and switch off our S2. Okay, so what we are saying that we will give pulses to S1 non-pulse at t is equal to zero. Okay. Let us say, okay, and then we will give the pulses to S2 switch. Okay, so like this, the pulses will continuously being given to the switches to switch on the switch. Okay, so if S1 is on, then what will be VL? So we have studied this, that when S1 is on, then the load voltage is V/2 because the source is V/2. 3-point source, V/2. So it will be V/2. So for T1 second, the load voltage is V/2. What about the current? That is flowing in the loop. Let us see. So at t is equal to zero, we were saying that minus I0 current was flowing in the loop. Now because the switch S1 is closed, so what should happen? The current should flow in the upper circuit. So let us say this is one. So the current in the load should travel from B to A as per above circuit if S1 is closed. It means suddenly the current has to jump from I0 to I1 value. No? Has to jump. I1 and I0 are having reverse direction. So suddenly जो I0 negative है वो positive होना है, लेकिन हमने एक inductor लिया हुआ है, तो inductor का क्या behavior है? It will not let the current instantaneously change. वो change कर सकता है, current उसमें inductor में change कर सकता है, लेकिन वो एक steady तरीके से, okay, एक smooth तरीके से, एक instantaneous तरीके से नहीं. जैसे कि यहाँ पे अगर I0 को I1 तक जाना है तो उसको ये इस तरीके से जाना होगा. ओके, I0 फर्स्ट इट विल रीच टू जीरो एंड देन इट विल इंक्रीज टू I1. बट इस सर्किट को अगर आप देखेंगे तो इस सर्किट में ये चीज पॉसिबल नहीं है. ओके, आपको I0 को जीरो करने के लिए एक पाथ देना पड़ेगा. I0 कौन से करंट किसने किस सोर्स ने जनरेट किया? I0 इस नीचे वाले सोर्स ने जनरेट किया था ना, और आपने S2 ओपन कर दिया तो I0 फ्लो कहां से करेगा? I0 के लिए तो कोई जगह ही नहीं है. तो इस सर्किट से इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू डू. If you are feeding an RL load, so what we do, we connect a diode across the switch. So let me make a separate circuit. So if this is S1 and this is our resistance and inductive load, okay, and this is your I0 current, the initial current. It is flowing in this direction. So what we need to do, just connect a diode across the switches, but in anti-parallel way. Means it is parallel. The diode D1 is connected in parallel to switch S1, but the current which the diode can take, it is in reverse. It is the it is direction is reverse to S1. Means in S1, if the current is flowing in this direction, the diode should conduct like this. So this is anti-parallel. Reverse current is flowing in the diode. Okay. Now just see what will happen. I0, which is traveling in the load, will take this path. Let me use a different color. So this I naught will take this path and reduce to zero. Okay, this I naught will travel opposite to the upper voltage source. Okay, so slowly and slowly means it will depend upon the time constant of the load L by R. That it will become zero, and as soon as it becomes zero, your I1 current will take over. Now your I1 current will increase from zero to I1 level. Okay. So till the I0 current is zero, which electronic component is conducting? It is neither S2 neither S1, it is D1. So here D1 is conducting. Okay, and in remaining portion, which will conduct? S1 will conduct. In this portion, S1 will conduct, because now the current has to take the positive path, a positive direction. It will travel from B to A. Okay, so it has to pass from the above voltage source, then to S1, then to load. Okay, now when now you are switching off your S1 and switching on your S2, now what will happen? So your current, let me take another ink. Let us take this brown one. Now I1 current has to flow, and I1 current is flowing in this direction. Now you are closing S1. So where this you are opening this S1. So where this I1 will go? So I1 will take, you can connect another diode which is in anti-parallel to S2. It will be diode D2, and now the current will take this path. Okay, and I1 will then decrease to zero as per the time constant of the load. Okay, it will decrease to zero, and then again it will come to I naught value. Okay, so for this duration, when current is coming to zero, your D2 is conducting, and for remaining portion, and for remaining portion, your S2 will conduct. Okay, and in this for this time, VL will be minus V2. It will be minus V2. Okay. So symmetrically, you can just draw the VL. and you can draw the current direction, current as well. Okay. So we can see here that two diode has been connected in anti-parallel to the switches, so that it can reduce the current flowing in the load to zero. So this is called half bridge inverter. Okay, let me take the black. Half bridge inverter. The advantage of using a half bridge inverter is that it just uses two switches to convert your DC quantity to AC quantity. Okay. And the disadvantage of this first is that it uses three point DC source. It is not normal. In this, we need plus terminal, negative terminal, and the zero terminal, the neutral terminal. Okay. Normally, the DC sources come with positive and negative, just two terminal, but for this we need a special DC source. And the second is this loss of voltage at output. Loss of voltage at output. Why there is a loss of voltage? Just see, you are taking a DC voltage source as to be V. V is the potential across the positive and negative terminal of the DC voltage source, the input source. And what is the output? Just see, the output varies plus V by 2 to minus V by 2. Okay. So the AC voltage source will have its maximum voltage as to be V by 2. So what is the power conversion here? Power conversion, if you can say V into I1, if you say this is the power input to the this converter, and what is the power output? It is V by 2 into I1. Okay, if you see, the efficiency will come out to be 50%. Yes. Okay, so this converter is having low efficiency. Okay, it can convert your DC source to AC source, AC supply, but there will be loss of voltage. If you are taking V voltage as the input DC, then you will get V by 2 at output. Okay, so to increase the efficiency of this inverter, we use a full bridge inverter circuit. So this I will take in the next lecture. So thank you for today. Thank you.